Please welcome the first of tonight's challengers for the Bacon Championship, from Grimsby, Kevin Hooper. Introducing to you firstly, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the blue corner short, Kim Will Selman. And the weigh-in yesterday, he scaled 9 stone, 3 pounds. His outstanding record reads 14 contests, 13 wins. 3 of those wins coming by way of knockout with just a single defeat. He comes to the ring this evening as the current Midlands area lightweight champion, presenting from Grimsby, Kevin Hooper. And opposing him, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the red belt shorts trimmed with black and gold. At the weigh-in yesterday, he sailed 9 stone, 3 pounds, 8 ounces. His outstanding record reads 20 contests, 16 wins, 4 of those wins made by way of knockouts, just 3 defeats and 1 draw. He comes to the ring this evening as a former Commonwealth title challenger, presenting from Ashton on the line, here is John final instructions, 10, 3 more rounds.
Remember, Yeah, that was a good competitive round, that, which I think John Kay's just edged. Started to force Hooper back in the middle of the round there. Got some clean shots, including a good powerful overhand right. So I think after the not splitting the first two, he's just gone in front now. So let's hope Johnny can carry on. That was another round for John Kay's there. Hooper started off sprightly, going backwards and sticking out his long arms and scoring with his jab, but Johnny seems to get the measure out then, and he got a bit scrapper, and then Johnny started to find a way through and push him back. So good round again for Johnny Kay's.
Second out, round five.
was a fantastic round by Johnny Kayes. Wasn't even close there. He never stopped going forward and pushed Stooper back all the time. He got through with some nice 1-2s on a regular basis, and he looks like to be pulling away now to win this English Super Featherweight title, which has been vacated by Gary Sykes. Not as clean cut as the previous round for John Kayes, but he did win the round. Got a little bit scrappy in parts, and I think he's just starting to rush his work now, so he needs to just slow back down, coming off the jab, following up with a big overhand, not overhand right, a straight through right that's been quite successful, and it's going to be an easy night's work for him.
Seven, nine, seven.
Good round there. Johnny Kay's just pinching it, but I think Hooper's corner sold him his behind, and he started to push in that fight forward there, which really and truthfully suits Johnny Kay's, because he's not like a pressure fighter. He's a good counter fighter, and he'd only been pressurising it because Hooper's not been entertaining it, but he managed to counter punch a few there, and he looked very good. Another close round, but I think Johnny Kay's slightly edged that there. Both fighters have got to be credited for the fitness, because the pace isn't slowing down, and it looks like it's going to go all the way now, and the only chance Hooper's got is getting a knockout. So I think in rounds 9 and 10 he's going to come out flying. Let's hope Johnny can master that, and I'm sure he will.
Thank you.
Well, as he expected, Hooper did come out of that going in the ninth round, and he actually suited Johnny Kayes, and he's still looking as fresh now as he is in round one. So credit to his conditioning, and I think his little bit of extra boxing ability is winning him the rounds, even though it is competitive fights. You know, Johnny's just a little bit too good for Hooper. Unless I'm completely wrong and Carl Greaves is right, it was a comfortable victory for Johnny Kayes. I can't see how they think they've won it at all. He did do okay in that last round, but the best they could have done is give him a draw. So my card's got Johnny Kayes about six rounds up, at least. So I don't think Carl Greaves is looking through the same sort of glasses as me. So I think it's an extra champion for VIP boxing tonight with Johnny Kayes. Thank you. Thank you.
John Cairns and Devin Hoover. After 10 hard fought rounds of championship action, here are the judges' score totals. Judge John Latham scores the contest 97-94. Sean Messer scores the contest 96-95. And Dave Parry scores the contest 97-94. All three judges in favour of the winner by way of unanimous decision. He is the new English Super Featherweight Champion, John T. Appreciation, please. A fine effort. Indeed. Kevin Hooper, Chairman of the Central Area Council of the British Boxing Club, Mr. Stephen Furness, has awarded the championship belt to the winner. Aston Netherlands, John Two Smokes Pigs. On behalf of everybody involved with tonight's promotion, on behalf of VIP Promotions, VIPBoxing.tv, we hope you've enjoyed tonight's championship action here from the Oldham Sports Centre. See you next week at the Reebok Stadium Premier Suites in Bolton for another superb evening of boxing brought to you by VIP Promotions. Have a safe journey home and enjoy the remainder of the weekend. Thank you.
Bolton's guys.